It's main event time on WCW Saturday night. Making their way to the ring will be the team of Raven and Horace of the Flock. And I guarantee you, yeah, there they are, the rest of the Flock.
You asked for it, you got it.
And Horace bringing his DOT memorabilia out there, the ever-present stop sign of Horace. And that man, the enigmatic leader of the Flock, Raven, never in a good mood.
Well, appropriately enough, the Flock leads the charge. Flock members, you know they're going to surround the ring. They're going to take on two ex-members of the Flock in our main event.
Saturn and Van Hammer will come to the ring next. Raven and Horace are in the ring with the Flock accompanying, and on their way to the ring right now, Mike, today, two former Flock members, Saturn and Van Hammer. This is going to be a war.
Saturn and Van Hammer obviously focused on their opposition in this matchup. Concentration level here isn't going to wane one bit. They share one thing in common, and it's a bond and a hatred for the man that we just saw in the ring, that close-up view of the Flock leader, Raven.
Breakups are always tough, Mike. And the breakup between Saturn and Raven was brutal. The breakup between Van Hammer and the rest of the Flock was brutal. Don't forget, Saturn and Van Hammer wrestled to see who would stay in the Flock, and now they're both out.
And they're both happy to be out if you talk to them.
Oh, yeah.
They say that it's the best thing as far as their career goes, as far as advancement in World Championship Wrestling, to cut all ties, to have no further association with Raven and those other Flock members.
If you want to advance your career in WCW, I suggest you change your last name to Goldberg. Last Monday night at the Georgia Dome, Goldberg became the World Heavyweight Champion, and this Monday on Nitro, you will get a shot to relive the moment. 41,000 plus in the Georgia Dome, standing and chanting Goldberg when he became the new King of the Hill, the top of the mountain, Goldberg, the new champ. Nothing beats a live Nitro, Mike.
Well, Scott, speaking of Nitro and big events, this Monday, July the 13th, Nitro returns to the MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas, Nevada, and tickets are still available at the MGM Grand Garden box office and Ticketmaster. Upcoming Nitro, San Antonio, Texas, on July the 27th, with tickets at the Alamo Dome box office and Ticketmaster, and we're headed to Denver on August the 3rd. Tickets for that big Nitro event available at Ticketmaster. One other note, Thunder, this upcoming Thursday, July the 16th, will be in Oakland, California. Tickets at the Arena box office and all Bass ticket outlets.
Raven just draped Saturn across the top. Dolphin Horace with a big boot to the face takes Saturn down. And this is something of a Bash at the Beach tune-up, because tomorrow night, one-on-one, Raven and Saturn will go at it, hopefully to settle it all in San Diego at Bash at the Beach.
Well, there has been a long-standing rivalry between these two. And when you hear the history, at least from what Raven tells us about family members being involved in the life, there's plenty of payback in store for Raven tomorrow night at Bash at the Beach as far as Saturn is concerned.
These two bonded in the land of barbed wire and came to WCW, each being the only friend the other had. They had nowhere else to go but to stick together. That's why
Saturn, oh man!
The leg sweep into the railing at ringside. That's why Saturn joined the Flock, but he did not like the control exerted by the enigmatic leader of the Flock, Raven, and he bolted. And now Raven wants his pound of flesh from Saturn. He's going to get a shot tomorrow night in San Diego. And Bash at the Beach, what a clothesline from Horace.
And if you listen to Raven tell the story, that bond goes back even further than Barbed Wire City. He has stories about how he and Saturn grew up as friends in school. Here's the cover of the big splash. Horace gets a two count. Also tomorrow, it's going to be one-on-one. We thought it was going to be a tag team matchup. That no longer the case. National Football League star Kevin Green of the Carolina Panthers is going to go into the ring against the largest athlete in pro sports, face-to-face with the Giant tomorrow night at Bash at the Beach.
Kevin Green may not know what he is getting himself into, stepping into the ring with the largest athlete in the world, the Giant. Cross body by Saturn, hooks the leg, and he got the two count on Horace. Oh, that was close. But tomorrow night, Kevin Green, you are a terrific football player. one of the best ever, inarguably, and the Carolina Panthers are very lucky to have you back, but I don't know. You haven't seen anything like the Giant. Cover by Saturn, two count on Raven. Kevin, you haven't seen anything like the Giant. 7'4", 500-plus pounds. Cover by Raven, two count on Saturn. That's going to be a war tomorrow night, Kevin. I hope you're ready.
And the Giant has such a huge edge, not only in power, not only in size, but also especially, Scott, in experience.
Oh, yeah. No question about it. This is what, Kevin Green's third professional wrestling match? Oh, and he's taking it against the Giant. Cannot wait for that one tomorrow night on pay-per-view.
One other matchup that we should mention as it pertains to tomorrow night's Bash at the Beach, and as we see flock members around ringside, it certainly comes to mind because it's going to be Kidman versus Juventud Guerrero. What a great cruiserweight high-flying matchup that should be.
They have torn down the house several times for World Championship Wrestling. I look forward to happen again tomorrow night at the Top Arena. Just going to collapse around because Juventud and Kidman are going to fly all over San Diego on pay-per-view.
It's going to be the battle of the seven-year itch, the roll-up, and a two-count only before Horace kicks out. Seven-year itch of Kidman against the 450 splash and the Hoovy driver of Juventud Guerrero tomorrow night at Bash at the Beach.
Tag made by Horace. Raven comes in and puts the boots to his former childhood friend, Saturn. Saturn is not moving very well at all. Hang on. Double underhook salto by Raven. Cover. Hooks the leg. Charles Robinson down and he got the two count on Saturn.
This is our preview of tomorrow night. One-on-one competition tomorrow evening on pay-per-view. And quickly, he makes the tag into Horace. There's the drop toe hold. And look at him use that five count to his advantage from the official Charles Robinson.
Cover by Horace on Saturn. He got the two count. We have seen Raven use that drop toe hold to cause serious injuries to other wrestlers, but it usually involves a chair up inside the ring. That time, just a straight drop toe hold, and Saturn is still down.
Yeah, ask the former Scotty Riggs about damage being done with that drop toe hold into a steel chair, although amazingly enough, Riggs, complete with eye patch, as we've all seen evolve, not only standing at ringside, but one of the members in high standing of the flock.
For all of Raven's mental problems, if you will, he is a very, very talented wrestler. Let's not forget that. He knows what he is doing inside the rope. Horace, the big man, 300 pounds, going up top and drops straight across Saturn. That's got to do it. One, two, and Saturn kicked out.
Last bit of energy, an adrenaline rush that time by Saturn, enabling him to kick out. Important at this point for him to get the fresh man Van Hammer in the ring.
Horace misses the clothesline. Saturn, the suplex. And Saturn wants to make the tag to Van Hammer. Saturn is fifth. There's the tag. Van Hammer, the tag to Raven. And here we go. Right hand from Van Hammer.
Oh, the right on Horace. Good night. Just what we expected. Other flock members getting involved. He's got the Cobra. Slammed him down to the mat.
Oh, and one for Sick Boy. And one for Riggs. And Van Hammer is cleaning house. There goes Horace. Straight over the top.
Oh, look down at the bottom of the screen.
Oh, no.
Saturn setting up the table.
Watch out. Van Hammer waiting on his... Oh, and he drops the double axe handle on Horace. Double axe takedown. Oh, got it. Quick drop kick. Caught Raven with the chair.
We knew that chair was going to backfire one time. Drop kick, and it went face first. Raven caught all of that steel chair directly in the face.
Yeah, you see Sick Boy walking in front of the ring. Saturn still on his knees. Looks like he's going up top. Hang on. Look at Van Hammer. Van Hammer has Horace on the table. Oh, boom!
What a splash off the top rope, crashing down through that table.
Call air traffic control. Saturn needs landing instructions. Now Van Hammer has the chair in the center of the ring. He wants Raven. He wants his former boss, the leader of the flock. Van Hammer.
Yeah, give him some of his own medicine.
Oh, no.
Reversal by Raven.
The drop toe hold into the chair. Oh, and the even flow DDT. That may do it. Cover. Hooks the leg in the three count. And Raven will go to Bash at the Beach tomorrow night. One-on-one against Saturn. But both men really had it taken out of them tonight on Saturday night.
What a gallant effort from Saturn and Van Hammer. The numbers game. All the flock members at ringside. They fought all of them off. That didn't even matter. Look at Lodi celebrate. Raven looks a little worse for wear, though, Scott.
I don't know that Raven knows where he is, but Lodi knows what's going on there. Horace, boy, did he take it from Saturn.
Wow, what a main event tag match on Saturday night.
WCW and NWO present Bash at the Beach. Diamond Dallas Page teams with the mailman Karl Malone tomorrow night on pay-per-view. They take on the Worm, Dennis Rodman, and his partner from NWO Hollywood, Hollywood Hogan. It's tomorrow night. It's Bash at the Beach on pay-per-view. We'll see you tomorrow night in San Diego at Bash at the Beach, Thursday on Thunder, and next Saturday night here on Superstation TBS.